So you might know that I keep a lot of calendar items going because that's what I do. I meet with entrepreneurs around the world and I have to put them on my calendar. Unfortunately, Google and Apple haven't really innovated in the calendar lately. So I'm seeing a lot of startups that are working on making our lives of scheduling better. And Magneto is right now showing me a new calendaring system, which is quite nice.
Hi, I'm Gadi Shamia, founder and CEO at Magneto. And a little bit about myself, Magneto is my third company. The first one was out of Israel. It was a business management software for small businesses. We sold it to SAP in 2002. That's how I moved to the US. And now my little company from Tel Aviv is hundreds of millions of dollar business for SAP and the baseline, the core of SAP's small business division.
Yeah. Anyway, so what makes you think you can take on Google and Apple with a calendar, a better calendar, right?
I took on business management, business software, and I end up being creating one of the most popular business management softwares in the world. So, you know, maybe. We're in Silicon Valley. We believe. We try to build things that are just better and see what the users say. At the end of the day, the users will decide.
Well, I'm glad there's people like you who exist because the big companies haven't innovated in calendar for quite some time. Tell me why I should consider your calendar versus just using Google Calendar or Apple Calendar or Microsoft Exchange, right?
And you're right. Exchange is a 20 years old product that if I ask you what's the last feature you remember that Microsoft added to it, you'll scratch your head for a very, very long time. And Google did a little bit by moving into the cloud, but did not innovate on top of it. On the other hand, we look at calendars and they're so important. This is how we manage our life, our appointments, personal stuff, work stuff. I remember that you even put buying jeans on your calendar.
Oh,
you told me that like a year ago. So everything that needs to get to get done is on the calendar, yet we still work with this 20 years old system that haven't evolved. So when we start working on Magneto, we ask ourselves, what are people missing in the calendar? What is a 2014, 2015 calendar can do that the 1996 calendar can't? And we end up focusing on several things. One of them is help you be on time for meetings. So being on time is a massive, massive issue, especially for people that work in meeting other people. If you're a salesperson or a business development person, being on time is not only essential, it's actually part of your ability to close a deal or not.
Yeah. So, or in case of Marissa Meyer, stay out of PR trouble.
Stay out of PR trouble.
Because she was late to a dinner and it became an international news story.
But she overslept. So I don't know if we can solve that. Maybe we just need stronger alerts before the meeting.
Yeah.
So the first thing we do, which is different than any other calendar, is we look for meetings with locations, venues or addresses, and we block predictive travel time for each one of those meetings. So we actually look at where you're going to live from. If for my next meeting, for example, I'm going to live here from the Rackspace studio. When's your next meeting? And what's the predictive travel time between these two points? And we actually block it on your calendar. So your coworkers will not attempt to schedule time at this time slot. And when we do that, we as the meeting gets closer, we monitor this travel. And if traffic changes, we let you know if you should leave earlier or leave later based on real-time traffic. And if, God forbid, you're late, we're also going to notify the people you're meeting with. And just to close this loop, we're even going to give you an automatic expense report for your miles at the end of the month. So
you
can use that.
Yeah.
We actually realize that people spend hundreds of dollars a month on traveling for work, and most of them don't expense them because it's just too hard.
Yeah. Let me see how you help me do all this, because I did the travel time in my head. I know how many minutes it takes to get to like Cisco and South San Jose, right?
Yeah, so, and a lot of people do that, and this is why so many people are late, because your head is never as accurate as a machine. It's a fairly tedious process, but let me show you an example.
Yeah.
So the first thing to know is Magneto is available both on an iPad, an iPhone, and on the web. I'll start with showing Magneto on the iPhone, and I'll switch to other UIs just so you can see how it acts in various UIs. So the first thing you would see is that for every meeting you have, whether it's personal work, like my doctor meeting here or my next meeting after, we automatically block travel time for the meeting. And we try to make it very fluid for the user. So if I'm trying to schedule a meeting on Friday, we didn't want the users to go through anything complicated. So this is meeting with Robert. The moment I put time in, we made it very easy to be able to select a location. I can type Cyclas, and I find Cyclas Coffee or any other address, and we're going to automatically calculate driving time. So there's actually no extra work from your side to calculate travel time. And we'll show you how long it's going to take. You can choose between driving, walking, biking, or even public transit. In this case, we show you every option you have for public transit, so you can pick the right one that works best for you. And once you've done, you just save the meeting, and you have the meeting with the travel time block on your calendar.
So one problem I notice in my life, and I don't know about anybody else, when I'm on my mobile phone and somebody calls me and says I need a meeting, I look up my calendar. I say, oh, 2 o'clock on Friday is open. How about then? They say yes. And often I'm busy because I'm in a lunch meeting or something, and I don't have time to sit there and figure out what the address is and all that stuff. So I have to do that later. Can I move to the web and then?
Clearly, if you have a meeting that doesn't have a location, like buy a keyboard over here, it's trivially easy to just go here and say, oh, where do I want to buy a keyboard, maybe fries, and just start typing something and find the right store or whatever it is. So it's very easy to go later and find whatever store or location or whatever else it is. This is just nearby. And once you edit, it will create a travel time and add it to your calendar. And this is, by the way, a task which is in the calendar.
Yeah.
So we try and make it
easy. Does it delimitate between task type of things versus meeting type of things?
Yeah, and this is very interesting. And actually, some of the inspiration, believe it or not, came from this Jeets discussion we had a year and a half ago when we started working on Magneto. We realized that almost everybody we talked with actually put tasks on their calendar. You're not that unique about it. People use it for reminders, like pay rent. People use it for buy gift for my friend, or work on the deck for my presentation. But because tasks are not involved people tend to forget them. Oh, somebody called me. I just gonna do it later. So when you create a meeting in Magneto, it can look like a task, like buy this keyboard, and there's a checkbox, and you can actually check it in the calendar. The other thing we do is we recommend tasks based on locations or based on people you're gonna meet. So if you're gonna be nearby a place this week, we're gonna pop a task to the top, like pick up this DSLR from Ellen just because you happen to have a meeting in the East Bay on Sunday. If you want to schedule it to your day, just take the task and just drag it to your day, and we'll automatically add a travel time for it, and it's gonna be on your calendar. If you fail to complete a task, we're gonna remind you. So, hey, incomplete task, gift ideas for Steve. Do you want to duplicate it because you just want to keep working on it, or you want to reschedule it?
Yeah.
So we actually built in tasks to your calendar so you can block time for them, so we can remind you to get them done, and they're just part of your day.
Yeah.
So your day...
Yes, does it help you make your calendar better? Because one thing I do, and it pisses Rocky off because he has access to my calendar too, is I'll put something like Flipboard on my calendar. What does that mean? Well, in my head, it means I'm going to Flipboard for a meeting with Mike McHugh. I don't need Rocky there, right? But Rocky's like, why didn't you just put Rocky not needed? Or why didn't you put Mike McHugh in there? Why didn't you put the address in there? Why didn't you put some details? I don't have time to put all that detail in there. But maybe if I spent half an hour a week going through all my calendar, I would clean it up and add some details that would help make the calendar work better and have better travel times. But would help me as well.
Yeah, it's a good question. Our focus was how do we make data entry as easy as possible, rather than trying to guess the right data, because you get so many wrong guesses when you try to guess what's right. What does Flipboard mean? Maybe you want to work on a presentation about them. Maybe you want to write about them. It's really hard to decide. So you made data entry really, really easy. One example is the autocomplete you've seen. We have actually special keyboards for everything. So you just say 5 p.m. instead of just typing or using the sadistic rollers that iPhone has. The other thing we've done is we try and make it super easy to move meetings from the web to your calendar. So for example, I got invited to this Facebook event, Friday Night Barbecue, and I want to add it to my calendar. I don't have to do anything complicated. I click on Magneto extension, it reads the information from the page, it shows me my calendar on that day so I can see if I'm available, and will automatically calculate travel time for me. All I need to do is just save it, and now it's on my calendar.
So it found the location off of this event?
Yeah.
and it figured that out and it added all of that automatically.
Yeah, and similar, if you go to a Yelp page and now I want to schedule lunch with you, again, all you need to do is click here. We're going to grab the restaurant name, the address, the link to the restaurant, show you my schedule here so I can find a day where I might have time and I don't have time here. Maybe I have time here. Click here, I can just schedule it. And if I want to add someone, like, you know, Leah, I'm just adding them, I'm sending them a meeting invite. So this is the process of creating a meeting from a Yelp page. And you can do it from Paperless Post, from Eventbrite, from many other sites that have either people information, location information, or event information.
Wow.
So again, it's a way, instead of guessing, just make it super easy for you to enter data into your system through this Chrome and the Firefox extension.
That's cool. So Chrome and Firefox, if you have Safari,
Safari tend to be the minority of our users. So yeah, we support Firefox and Chrome just because they're
the vast majority.
It's a big minority, not necessarily among our users, and people don't tend to use. We actually went back and checked. Users don't tend to use extensions on Explorer.
Does this sit on top of Google or Exchange? Because other people are hooked up to those systems. You know, if you're at work, you're on Exchange, so people can see that you're busy on that time, right?
So it's a cloud-based, Magneto is a cloud-based calendar, and if you look at this user specifically, the red meetings are Exchange meetings, and I've just made this person really, really busy, huh? So the red meetings are my work meeting, they're synced to my Exchange calendar, the blue meetings are my personal one, they're synced to Google. It's all cloud sync, so whether the apps are on or not doesn't matter, it happens in real time. And every meeting you create in Magneto will automatically sync to Google or Exchange, depends on time and date, or vice versa. We actually do some smart guesses. If I create a meeting on Saturday, we automatically guess that this meeting is personal. You see the button is blue, it's automatically go to personal. If I create the same meeting on, you know, Wednesday afternoon, red, go to work.
Yeah.
And the other thing we do, which plays really nice between the two calendars, not only do we sync from, for example, your work meeting from Magneto to your work calendar, we do a smart feature which is cross-sync. We allow you to automatically block time for personal meetings on your work calendar. So this is a scenario where you want to go to get a spa treatment in the middle of the day, but you don't want your coworkers to know what you do, but at the same time you want your calendar to show that you're not available. If you set Magneto this way, every personal meeting you create will automatically block time on your work calendar without the details. So this is my work calendar on Outlook. And as you can see, someone with access to my calendar can see full details of my meetings, like Joe and so on. But when I go to personal meeting, they see driving personal busy in Palo Alto. So we automatically block times from your personal calendar, but we didn't share with your organization what exactly it is that you're doing, just so you're gonna be
out. That's nice. Now, how do you make a business out of this? Do I pay for the calendar?
So Magneto is entirely free right now, and in the future we're going to offer business features that we'll charge for. But right now the product is entirely and completely free.
Very cool. And it's not on Android right now. It's a web, which does work on Android probably.
So Magneto is on iPad, iPhone, web, and as a browser extension. We are working on Android version. We have some Android users that benefit from the fact that both their calendars are connected. They can get travel time. They can block personal time because the features are server-side. They can still get some of Magneto, but we don't have a native Android app yet on the App Store.
And keep giving me a tour. What else makes this different from Exchange Calendar or Google Calendar?
So here's another neat feature. Actually one of my favorites. I'm going to show a couple of small favorites and then a very important feature. This is coming from my personal experience. So your day on a map. I started my life in sales. In my first startup, I would go around and sell to customers. And my first days of sale looked like a meeting here, a meeting here, a meeting here, and a meeting there. So it was this very complicated day. And I asked the sales assistant who scheduled the meeting for me to print a map for me with my day. So we actually took this idea and built it into Magneto. And when you look at each one of your days, you can actually see this is my home, this is my work. Here's a to-do I can get along the way. Here's a to-do near a meeting. So you can actually look at a to-do near a meeting. Here's my first meeting of the day. So you literally have a kind of very fluid idea of how your day will look like on a map. So for somebody that travels a lot for work, it's going to be a lifesaver, especially when you travel in places that you're not familiar with.
Well, that's a really interesting insight. And it'll be interesting to see where you go with that, because if you give me that calendar today, I don't have lunch yet planned. And I would probably look for lunch nearby. Or between two of those spots, right?
Yeah, we saw playing with the to-dos, which is, if you're going to be near a place where you have a to-do tagged for this place, why wouldn't we just mark it and make sure that you pay attention to it? Yeah. So if you look at, and every, when you look at your different days, if I look at my Sunday, for example, different to-dos might pop as the recommended to-dos based on the day. So this is kind of one nice favorite feature that I have, is the ability to share a calendar, and you can do it obviously from the phone and from the web. So this is the scenario where I want to find time for a meeting on ad hoc basis with someone. We don't have a working relationship. I just want to share my calendar so we can find a time. One thing we do is we allow users to share their schedule for short term periods. So I can have a meeting with Robert.
Yeah.
And I limit it to 2 weeks, and I can write you a message. Let's discuss the project. And then I invite whoever I need to invite. So I invite Emma and Leah, which are two people I want to have in this meeting. And what we're going to do is we're going to send these two people an email and say, hey, here, Gadi is sharing his calendar with you for the next couple of weeks so you can find time for a meeting. So if you go to Emma, she will get an email, say, hey, meeting with Robert, find time, let's discuss the schedule, click to see Ben's schedule. And immediately she gets access to my free busy. So without doing anything, she can see when I'm available, when not. If she's a Magneto user, she can in one click import her calendar on top of mine. So now we have this combined availability of both of us. If she's not a Magneto user, she can just indicate the time it will work best for her. There's a comment tool, she can write a comment, you know, Monday is best. And as you can see, I'm getting notification in real time that she's interacting with my shared schedule. And if I go back now to Ben, the initiator of this meeting, so Ben is going to get alerted. Monday's best. He can see the calendar. He can see the preferred time. And from here, just create a meeting between all the meeting participants. We capture automatically the meeting participants. We capture the notes. And you can just save the meeting, and the process is over. So wow. It's a very easy way to share a snapshot of your calendar for the next couple of weeks, so people can, instead of doing the guesswork of Monday at 3, Wednesday at 4, can just show your calendar, people interact with it, and find a time for a meeting.
You said that you're doing expense reports for driving distances, right?
Yes.
Are you actually tracking my phone so you know where I actually went? Because right now, on the way to the next meeting, I need to drop Rocky off at the BART station, so that might add a couple of miles.
So we do have a route calculated, and we do snap to route if you took a whole different route. What we try to do is we try to give you, and here's how it looks, we try to give you an easy reporting of all your trips. You can say, I want to work, or personal meetings, usually people want only work for a specific time period, and then you search, and we allow you to do some editing. So if you look at this and say, oh, you know what, Netflix actually returned home after that at a return trip, you can do that and save it. And the cool feature is that once you're done, you can send it to Expensify in one click. So if you use Expensify, which yeah. I guess you are, one click, it's in Expensify. So we're connecting Expensify account to Magneto, and then you can, in one click, move all these expenses and get reimbursed in your...
We're actually using Workday here, but I use Expensify as well, so...
Yeah, if you use anything else, you can actually download the CSV, and yep. then just import it to your CSV. And this can be hundreds of dollars a month that you can save just by avoiding the 2 hours a month it will take you to figure out where you traveled and how many miles you have to get reimbursed for.
Yeah, very, very nice. How are you funding this company?
So the company is funded by a seed fund called Hillspin. This is the same company that actually funded Expensify, Bleacher Report, Check, which just got acquired by Intuit, Livefire, which I'm sure you know.
Yep.
So they're always first investors in startups, and they typically support both consumer and enterprise products.
Well, I can't wait to get this because I need some of these things.
I'll send you an invite
in the
right
worst
away.
Way. So thank you so much for coming in. Where do we learn more about it?
You can go to magneto.me or download Magneto in the App Store.
Very cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Right.